Okay, guys, it's Friday and I'm already at the Wetherspoons in near where Toys R Us used to be. They're all preparing for Wembley. Let's go up the greens. Oh, we're on our way to Wembley. Walking through Birmingham now. This is the start of part two of this weekend's videos. Oh, I'm so tired and I'm so nervous for tomorrow. Up the Argyle. We've made it. We have made it.
The next day.
It's match day. Come on, you greens. Here we go then. I cannot wait. All right, guys. So while I'm waiting for the train, we're back. We're back with another video. It's the day. It's the big day. It is the big day. I've already said, obviously, when these all get uploaded, you've seen part one, the build up to it all. I went to Derby Ipswich in the meantime. Ipswich won the game 2-0, unfortunately. I thought Derby got robbed of a goal, but it is what it is. It means Ipswich have closed right up to Argyle and Sheffield Wednesday in the League One table. But this is part two of the build up at Wembley, and it is the big day itself. It's none other than the big day itself. So here we go then. Here we go. Honestly, I cannot get more excited than I am now. An underground train has just turned up, but it's not mine because it's not going to Wembley, so I'm gonna wait for that to happen. So yeah, honestly, it is the Papa Johns final today. I'm in London. It's going to be my second ever time to Wembley Stadium. My first ever time was in 2018 with my family because my dad booked us tickets to watch Chelsea, Manchester United, because he is a Chelsea fan. Chelsea won the game, thank God. Obviously, Chelsea's my second favourite team because of my dad. But this is my first time with the Mighty Greens and I am so, so excited. Unfortunately, the last time we were at Wembley Stadium, we lost 2-0 in the League Two playoff final to AFC Wimbledon, which was an absolute disaster for us all. Absolute disaster. I couldn't believe it, as we could have put Devon and Cornwall back on the map, but again, a league higher, but instead another London team decides to join League One instead. But that is aside now. That was all the way back in 2016. Unfortunately, I couldn't go back then, but this is different. I watched it on my TV. It was shocking. It was an awful performance. But this is my first time at Wembley Stadium with Plymouth Argyle. And I don't think I've ever been more gassed in my life about this. This is one of the biggest and best days of my life. I'm hoping this can happen. But that's only if we win, of course. It's a big one. Plymouth Argyle versus Bolton Wanderers. The last time we played Bolton, we drew 0-0 with them at Bolton's ground. I'll put the link in the description to give you all a reminder. And back in August, just before I moved back down to Plymouth, we beat Bolton 2-0 at Home Park. Sixth game of the season. And one of the games that pretty much showed how good our home form honestly is. But yeah, no, honestly, it's a big one today. I cannot wait. It's Wembley Stadium. It's Argyle v Bolton. Hopefully it doesn't go to extra time or penalties. We need the win. But more importantly, I just want to enjoy the day, because today is not as important as the League One promotion race, because the most important thing of this month in April is getting promoted to the Championship. So it's not the end of the world if we do lose this final, but I'd love to win at Wembley, because Wembley would be amazing, wouldn't it? I would love to win at Wembley, it'd be amazing. So yeah, I am now on the Jubilee line, heading to Wembley Stadium. So yeah, let's get the win, guys. Come on, you Greens. Up the Janners, up the Argyle, up the Pilgrims, up the Plymouth, up the Greens. Come on, you boys in green. Right, see you all at Wembley. We're here, we've made it. Big day ahead. Come on, you Greens! Darren, how are we feeling into today?
Green Army!
We're at Wembley Stadium.
We are.
Last time we were here was 2016. Let's not go into that. But honestly, how are you feeling coming into today against Bolton?
Very, very confident.
Yeah,
Green
same,
Army, brilliant season. I reckon we win 2-1.
2-1 you're going for. Who's That's scoring right. for both Argyle and Bolton today?
Oh, I don't know about Bolton, but I think we'll definitely have Ryan Hardy on the score
sheet. Ryan Hardy on the score sheet, fair yeah. enough. So you don't think it'll go to extra time or penalties
no,
at all?
No, we don't need that.
Fair enough. Definitely more confident than me then, so I'll give you that. Fair play. Where do you think we're going to finish end of the season?
Top.
I hope so. This is the way I look into today. We've got to win today, but if we don't, it doesn't matter, because we've got to go for top two. Because right. Wednesday drew, Ipswich won yesterday, so that's pressure on us.
Plymouth for shit.
No.
Absolute joke.
And that's just ruined the entire video. Better than where they are in the table. But yeah, no, cheers for coming. Oh, actually, before you leave,
yeah.
Can you give me your favourite Argyle chant?
Argyle are massive everywhere we go.
That's everything spot on about that. All right, now I've got to get past the swarm of traffic. But, oh by the way, can I just say, by the way, you're all going to meet a special guest in this video. So we'll get to that in 5 seconds. I don't care, but this is going to scream Wembley all over it, hopefully, for us. I'm going to shout it now. Green Army!
Response.
Right, we're here. Let's go. I cannot wait. It's 12 o'clock and already the atmosphere is mental. Look at that. Ah. Right, we are here. Come on. Let's shut these Northerners up. Come on, you Greens. All right, guys. We're at Wembley and The special guest is now here, that I've been saying all this time before this video. Not an Argyle fan, but still in the Argyle end anyway, and also just a guest that I've wanted to get on the channel anyway. Meet Cambridge fan Alfie. How are we doing,
Hello,
mate?
Hello everyone. I'm alright, mate. I'm alright. How are you?
Yeah, not bad. Obviously, as a Cambridge fan, are you, despite your club not being here today, are you excited so much for this game?
Yeah, I'm buzzing. Yeah. Every time at Wembley, it's 73,000 sold today, but what, 38,000 in the Argyle end?
Yeah, no, that makes sense.
It's going to be nice. It's going to be buzzing in that concourse in the game as well. So Cambridge United will never get to Wembley, so I might as well come here.
You never know. Always keep the faith.
If they go relegation playoffs, we'll be there. Well,
don't forget 2021. He came up as well that season as well.
Yeah, true. So yeah, that's true.
It was second behind Cheltenham, wasn't it? That season.
It was. Yeah.
So I remember how amazing Cheltenham were that season. I remember they had Man City in the FA Cup as well. So all that. Really. What's your score prediction for today then?
So I've been saying all day 1-1, it's going to go extra time. It's not going to go penalties, it's going to go Argyle win in extra time.
I'll take that. And limbs in our end as well.
Absolutely.
Who's scoring then for us today?
Ryan Hardy.
Everyone's saying Hardy will do it today. I can imagine a massive Hardy's on fire at Wembley
will
today.
Be, trust me.
It would be fantastic. That makes sense. From your point of perspective right now, where do you think both Argyle and Bolton are going to finish come end of the season?
So, Argyle, Hurricane, automatics.
Oh, I hope.
That's Bolton.
I'm s***ing myself for this April coming.
I don't know about Bolton, except they dip form, but I've got eighth, just missing
eight?
Out.
Eight?
Just missing
okay.
out.
Do you think Derby will stay in it or drop out? So who's going to take Bolton's place in the top six then? Wickham. He's gone Wickham. He's gone Wickham. I mean, I hope it's not, because that's the last team I'd want in the playoffs if
you
we finish third.
I
hate playing them. I hate playing them. So, just because I just know if we come third and they come sixth, I'm like, that's it, we're out. Because they'll just play anti-Vile football all game, and then
everyone hates Wickham football. Let's be
honest. Yeah. Oh, 100%. 100%. While you're here, actually, though, aside from Argyle Bolton, how are you finding? Might be a bit of a super question, but how are you finding Cambridge this season so far?
Well, there's the ups, not many, but mainly downs. But yesterday against Port Vale, we did get an away win for the first time since October. So
that was a brilliant win. That's a fantastic win.
But it's a bit up and down, but you've got to back the team home and away. Really,
oh, 100%, 100%.
So it's brilliant, I love it.
Who would you say has been Cambridge's best performance and result of the season so far in League One? You did beat Wickham away.
We did,
you?
Beat
same
Wickham
as us.
That was the last away win other than yesterday. I'd say best player this season is probably James Brophy.
Yeah.
My style, man, I love him. I'd do anything to back that life, but he's really improved this season.
Yeah, no, that makes sense. That makes sense. Do you think you'll stay up or do you think you'll go down? As it stands.
Down.
It has, because obviously you won yesterday.
Our goal will send us down.
You know what? I want Cambridge to stay up, so I'll feel bad for Alfie if that happens. So I want us to get promoted against Bristol Rovers, because, well, they love us, really, don't they? So yeah. We've got Shrewsbury away before you guys. I hope we get it then, because that'd be some massive away win as well. Been playing very well, apart from yesterday, because they got hammered 6-0 by Charlton. Yeah, who do you think will join you then going down? I think Forest Green have
gone
already. They've just lost to Portsmouth yesterday.
And then we'll come 23rd. And then I reckon Morecambe and...
So Morecambe have not been great lately, haven't we? That's who we've got next week.
Morecambe haven't been relegated in 103 years, so...
That's who we've got next week, and that's not going to be easy for us, because Derek Adams knows off the top of the back of his head.
Yeah, exactly. Morecambe and Burton.
He'll go in Burton, fair enough. Yeah, of course. What's your name, pal?
Jack.
Yeah. We've got another Jack here. How are we doing, mate?
Good, mate, I'm good.
What's the score prediction for today?
3-2 Bolton, sorry.
Oh, don't worry about it. Well, to be fair, I've already said in my video, if we lose today, we just got to immediately put it behind us. I just want to enjoy the day as we can.
Exactly.
And also, going up is far more important.
Someone came from myself as well. Yeah. So I'm a groundhopper as well, so I've just come in.
Yeah. Honestly, I've waited 13 years for this moment if we go up this season. So,
13 years to be championship, haven't
we? Exactly. Like, I grew up with us being in the championship, and I remember reacting to myself in the taxi on the way home from school as a 12-year-old kid going, how the f*** are we down in League 2 already?
I still remember when you're League 2, Argyle used to be championship, really used to be the conference as well. Look how far we came down.
Oh no, exactly. Yeah, that's what I mean. That's what I mean. Coming up to League 1 itself is
massive
brilliant.
So last time we're League 1, I wasn't born, so... years ago, whatever. But no, it's good to see us. But this year, I can't see us staying in the League 1. I'm sorry, I can't. Shame, but... Oh well, League 2 is.
Oh, here's a question, actually. If you do go down, how do you think you'll do next season, as it stands, in League 2?
Mid-table.
Mid-table?
Yeah. We'll get stuck there for a few years.
Yeah. So it took us 20-odd years to get up to League 1, so who knows? So hopefully perform 40, but so it happens.
And if we do finish playoffs and we do get a certain neighbours of yours, we'll try our best to beat them.
Yeah.
I went there in February and it was an absolute disaster class, so...
Well, so we lost 1-0 there, don't goal, so...
I still think you'll beat them in the derby in a few weeks.
Maybe. That's the
but everyone thinks Exeter's going to smash us, so I'm not looking forward to that.
So you've got the same base there next time.
But they have been, apart from yesterday against Fleetwood, they have been playing well lately. I don't know. I think it could be a draw as it stands, but I'm confident Harding could get a winner at Exeter.
So far, I'm here with him, I don't know. I have no idea what it's going to be like.
No, that makes sense. So, are you the same as Alfie? Do you think Cambridge will come 23rd?
22nd,
okay. So I know you have got Forest Green on the last day, to be
fair. Yeah, I've got Burton Aki as well.
That's a massive game coming up as well, yeah. Well, after what I saw from Aki last week at Scum, I personally think they're down anyway. I thought they looked dreadful. So who knows. But cheers for coming on, lads.
Nothing beats a Wembley trip without that. Anyway,
That's what that is. Pasties versus pies. So yeah, come on. That's Bolton fans for you. Wembley, oh my god. Look at that beautiful stadium. I can't wait for this. I honestly cannot wait for this. Right. Green Army! Look at this, amazing support. All right, best moment of today. Yeah, I'm joined by a fan who has been subscribed to the channel since I was on 50 subs all the way at the beginning. It's been a long while, September, October. Anyway, Ishan, Argyle fan, welcome to the channel. How are you feeling coming to today?
I'm feeling quite happy, mate. Excited.
Yeah, it's my first time at Wembley with Argyle, so I'm excited myself, to be fair. What's the score prediction?
2-1 Argyle.
2-1 Argyle. Yeah. Who's getting on the score sheet?
Hardy and Mumba.
Everyone's saying Hardy today.
Yeah.
I obviously, we can all hope. Is there anyone for Bolton, though, we need to look out for today?
Dion.
Okay. Is that who your scorer for Bolton is, by any chance?
Probably.
Okay, fair enough. And main question of all, are we going up this season?
Yeah, win the league.
We're going to win the league. That is what we need to hear. That's what we need to hear. I've already said to everyone already, after today, even if we lose today, forget about today, focus on the 8 games left. And get back to where we belong. Simple as that. So, yeah. But, yeah, you think we'll win the league then? Who's going up then? Ipswich on Wednesday at the moment? Who do you think? You think Ipswich? So you think Ipswich will come second then? Fair enough. I've said it ever since January that it'll be us and Ipswich going up, so who knows. But as soon as I said that, Wednesday hit their top form. So, yeah, who knows. Before we end this video, I asked this to everyone. I kind of ripped off Alex Griffin's idea for this, but it doesn't matter. Can you give me your favourite Argyle chant?
Like, sing it.
Up to you.
Shuey is our leader.
It's Shuey our leader. Oh, what a chant. Just look at the support while welcoming myself to Wembley. I cannot wait. All right, guys. So I'm joined by Andrew and Chris, two Bolton fans here. Guys, how are we feeling coming into today?
Great day, confident, yeah.
Fair enough. Yeah, I like the confidence, to be fair. What's the score prediction for today then?
2-1.
Argyle or Bolton?
Not sure, either.
Oh, okay,
Bolton,
fair enough.
Hopefully. Could be either way, but I think it'll be only one goal will be in it.
I've gone with a 1-1 draw and goes to penalties, yeah. So...
No, we don't want
that. I don't want that either, but... I just have a feeling that will happen, but... Yeah. Obviously, I was at Bolton back in January, the 0-0 draw. Yeah. What did you make of that game back then? I will admit, you're so much better than us, yeah, that game.
Yeah.
I look back at that game and the Ipswich game, like, I'm so glad we got points in those games, because it's got us to where we are now in the table. But obviously, who's getting on the score sheet today?
Dion Charles, I think.
Dion Charles for you guys. Anyone for us?
Ryan Hardy,
yeah. Everyone's saying Ryan Hardy today will score, so I'm looking forward to that. And where do you think you'll finish come end of the season as it stands?
Fourth or fifth, I think.
Confident you'll get playoffs?
Yeah.
Even with Derby opening it up yesterday. Yeah. I went to Pride Park yesterday, the neutral, when I said I wanted Derby to win, because Ipswich are now right on our tail on the table.
Yeah, I think we might be back here with you again in next month anyway, you never know.
What,
you
don't back want up it. There with us?
No, back here at the playoffs. Oh, no, you don't want it, but I think it might end up that way.
It might do, I don't know yet, but I said back in January, us and Ipswich would get top two, and I know that's still on the cards, but the minute I said that, Wednesday hit top four, and now they're in awful form.
Yeah.
So it could be one of us fit three, even Barnsley if they got in, so yeah. So who knows. Can you give me your favourite Bolton chant by any chance?
Yeah.
Don't have to sing it, you can just say it if you want.
We're the one and only Wanderers.
You love that chant, don't you? Yeah, no, fair enough. That's all right, no problem. And as you say, fourth or fifth you'll finish come end of the season. Yeah, that's fair enough. As it stands, if you do end up in League One next season, where do you think you'll finish next season? Because I was going to say, at the moment, I will be honest, I have got you and Derby to go up next season.
Hopefully. If we end up in it again,
Fair enough. All right, cheers for coming on, guys. Two more Bolton fans here, Andy and John. How are you feeling coming into today, guys?
Very positive. I think it's going to be a good day for us.
I've just said to these two already, I've already said, even if we do lose today, I'm not going to be too fussed because the league is far more important. And we need
that's
to be back
true.
To
yeah,
where
yeah.
we feel we deserve to be next season, which is the EFL Championship.
Absolutely.
And I grew up with us being in that league as well. So it's been a long 13-year wait.
Okay, well,
so I hope it happens this season, but we'll see.
I'm not confident about Bolton winning today, so I think you'll win today.
You will win today.
I just hope we can join you in the Championship next year.
Fair enough.
That's the important thing, isn't it?
It's not out of the question, yeah. It depends how you do in the playoffs, to be fair. Yeah. So, yeah. Do you think you'll get playoffs as it stands?
I think we might knock you off top spot, actually.
Fair enough.
I think that's highly unlikely.
So, what are you going to say? Bolton to win the league, us to come second?
I think so, yeah.
I'll take that either way. We're still top two, so I'll take that. It'd be bloody hilarious seeing Ipswich and Wednesday both in the playoffs. That'd be so funny.
Thanks, Jack.
No problem. So you think we'll win today? Who do you think's going to score?
Charles.
So is that the one we need? Is that the one we do need to look out for?
Yes,
today?
Yeah, absolutely.
And they,
fair enough. Where do you think you'll finish at the end of the season?
Sixth.
Okay, so that's still playoffs anyway. Another Bolton fan here. What's your name, pal?
Andy.
Nice to meet you, mate. What's the score prediction today?
2-1 for us.
Oh, okay. That's the first Bolton win. Who's scoring today?
Dion Charles
first, and then Kieran Lee the second.
Anyone for Argyle you're nervous for today?
No, it's been on goal.
Yeah. Oh, God. We're not used to them either.
Dion Charles on goal.
Read Army!
I was going to say, imagine working in these turnstiles. It'd be absolutely mental.
We've made it to Wembley. Here we go, my second ever time here, my first time with Argyle. I'm buzzing. Two more Argyle fans here, Ash and Ryan. Guys, how are we feeling coming into today?
I'm a Bolton fan.
What a start.
No, I'm doing it. I'm all in. Positive. I reckon we're going to do it 2-1.
Fair enough. 2-1 to go.
Yeah,
what's the score?
1-0.
Okay. Who's scoring today?
Hardy's
on fire, we love to hear it. Mumba.
Yeah, Mumba. I reckon Mumba.
That's my other favourite stat as well. 20 people finished at the end of the season.
Top.
I can't wait. I'll take second at least.
I'll take second as well,
man. So, yeah. And one more thing. Can you give us your favourite Argyle chant?
Argyle!
Class, mate. Thank you. Right, we're going to enter. Argyle! Oh my God! Look at it! Gillespie, Houghton, oh my God! Look at it! Amazing! Come on! Come on, Joe! Come on! Danny's playing. Ballymumba! Oh, Callum Wright's starting. Fair enough, Stewie. And Matete. Why didn't I get myself a flag? Oh well, it doesn't matter though. I want to enjoy the game. Oh, this is amazing. Azaz is on the bench. Hills and a coast that's been blessed. And inside of the sound lie the free Plymouth towns, where everyone's known as a Janners down in Plymouth. We're all known and our own football team, Plymouth Argyle Supreme, are the finest this beautiful county has seen. Every player of every nationality, when they pull on the green, they're all chatters. Chatters! Chatters! Down in Plymouth, we're all known as chatters. Banks off the Tamar to the edge of Dartmoor, the land where our spirit and faith still endure. Times may come, we will beat on Drake's drum. Oh, I love that. Genuinely the best Argyle atmosphere I've ever been to in my life. And it's not even at home park. Huge game, huge game. Let's beat these lot. Massive, absolutely massive. Read our bay! Look at that, just massive in every single way. Amazing. Oh, Kyle! Oh my god, they're starting Katunga. I'll take that any day of the week. But this is who we're here for. Come on! Hey! 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 Here we go then. Oh, I cannot wait. Here we go, we're away, we're away. Come on, Green Army. You're taking the mic. You're joking me. Not already. Bloody Kyle Dempsey. Number 22, Kyle Dempsey. We have not come to Wembley to concede this early.
Go on, I'll stop that punch. Oh, Kyle!
Oh, Kyle! I cannot believe that. What up, boys?
No. We need to wake up. Been a dreadful start. What the, hear that roar? What the frickin' hell are we doing? Come here for my club and for hopefully reaching 1,000 subs at the end of this season, and then we've passed 7 minutes and we've had this Maloney of a start. Just had to be written in the stars, didn't it? This is no. Get rid of it! I have hated this first half so far. Yeah. Well, they got their Dion Charles prediction right. Absolute bullshit. Ten minutes and it's freaking 2-0 to them. Minutes at Wembley for this utter garbage. Freaking come on, Argyle, wake up! Oh, shut up! No one there to help. Watch it be free, watch it be free! Thank God for that, but this is so freaking poor. No. Thank God, Cal, thank you. That was genuinely an absolute joke of a first half. And I don't want to talk about it, and I'm going to passionately rant in a minute. I don't want to talk about it. I could absolutely rant on like heck on what's going on. I will do later on, but not at the moment, because right now, obviously, it's half-time, Bolton 2, Plymouth Argyle 0, but right now I've got Janner's on tour with me. Guys, how are we feeling after that?
It's just terrible. I think the occasion has got to us again, I think, just like in 2016.
We never do well at Wembley.
We don't.
I don't know, but... Despite our terrible first half, who has actually been our best player?
Who? Callum Burton.
Yeah.
He made a crucial save.
I agree. Yeah. I don't know what Callum Wright's doing. He's been absolutely atrocious.
Mumba's
not playing great either, which is a disappointment because he's been our best player. Come on, you Greens! At least there's one positive. So I'm still queuing for food. Oh, my English is so bad. But second half is going to be, well, I think it's kicking off now. So I'm definitely grabbing some food before I get down there. But this is where I didn't give you my thoughts at half time, didn't I? So anyway, but yeah, it was what I got to be honest. What I watched there was. It's not even today I'm worried about. It's not even today. It's the last eight games after today I'm worried about. We've got to. If we lose today, we've got to get that form back if we want to be in top two this season, because that has not been good enough at all from none of them, not a single one of them apart from Callum Burton. Bolton deservedly 2-0 up, and the lads have got to be more freaking in it. I told you all, this is a make or break April, and this is not the start we wanted. It's over, it's over. Unless we win 4-3. I've just got back and it's 3-0 Bolton. It's not even today I'm worried about. How the f*** are we going to go up if we're going to play like this? When we got f***ing Morecambe next week. And it's even more embarrassing that Katrunga scored against us. The minute I sit down, they score. We got freaking Derek Adams next week. How the hell are we going to go up playing like this? And in a minute, it's going to be a battle of who's the biggest dog on coming second between us and Sheffield Wednesday. Because at the moment, Ipswich look like they're going up, no problem. And we're being torn apart by such an inconsistent team at the moment. Genuinely freaking useless we've been today. That's a replay of the goal. Bottom right, 3-0 Bolton. I hate to say it, I don't want to be a pessimistic, but I hate to say it, I think it's over. But like I've said, I'm not worried about today. I'm worried about the freaking last eight games. I want to go up. If you're an Argyle fan here and said you'd rather win this than go up, then you're stupid. This game has been an absolute catastrophe. Unless we do something here. Fucking wake up!
Exactly that.
Oh, fuck off. Alright, while the second half's going on, freaking disaster. We have got another Argyle fan here. Tommy, how are we feeling off that?
It's not looking good. It's not looking good. They're not playing
out. Like I've said already, like I said already, if we lose today, it's not today I'm worried about. It's the freaking last eight games I'm worried about. I want to go up, for God's sake. And how are we going to go up playing like this?
Exactly. That's what I don't think they'll be playing like this for the rest of the games.
Yeah.
One of them, innit?
That's what I mean.
Should I do it?
Yeah, go for it.
You're dirty, Northern.
It'll get bleeped out, but I'll keep it in, obviously. 100%.
You have to mute that bit out.
Yeah, I have to, but it's fine. It's fine. I'll still keep it in, though. Despite our dreadful first half, anyway, or in fact, game in general, who would you say has been our best player overall so far?
So far. I haven't seen anyone, really.
Yeah, because it's been a poor performance altogether.
It's not how they normally play, really, is it? It's not normally how they play, is it?
It's been a recipe of disaster this weekend, this week to me. Because yesterday I went Derby Ipswich as a neutral. When I say that, I wanted Derby to win, obviously. But now Ipswich are right on our arses. So.
Hopefully it's 4-3 end of game. But it's not gonna
happen. I've just said it's over unless we win 4-3. Unless we win 4-3.
You watch the comeback.
To be fair, we're known for comebacks.
We'll end this when it's 4-3, alright? We'll restart this when it's
4-3. Okay, all right. Well,
see you in a bit.
Hang on a second. Before you go, as it stands anyway, where do you think... Oh, hang on a minute. Well, good thing Burton's cleared that. Anyway, where do you think we will finish come end of the season?
End of the season?
Yeah.
First or second,
which I'll take
being
anyway.
Being truthful.
Exactly.
I still think we'll do it,
but yeah. We can't do it if we're playing like this. Cheers for coming on.
We'll come back when we're 4-3 up, right?
Yeah. Seriously, what are we doing? F-
3-0, 60 minutes. It feels like 7-0 right now to Bolton. It's been that bad of a game. It's Dion again. Useless. Oh, fuck off. Prats. Wembley. I don't think I could be this more annoyed. In what could have been a weekend that was meant to be the best of my life has just turned into an absolute asthmal of darkness. Deserve nothing from this game. Absolutely nothing. Although, having said that, what was that? And this is just proof on how dreadful some of our support is. I mean, just look at it. Ones staying here are amazing, but the ones that are just buggering off now, unless they're actually going for purpose reasons, but they're just going just because we're losing. F*** off. I guess we know the title of my two next videos then. Two terrible episodes. And this is the first time I think Bolton's... This is the first time Bolton's going to beat us since the 90s. Literally what he said. That's it.
The winners of the 2023
my life. That was so embarrassing. Worst performance of the season, bar none. Forget all of our League One hammerings. That was our worst performance of the entire season, that was. Mumba had his worst game of his career for us. God, this is going to be a hard 8 games. I can't believe it. Never win at Wembley. We never win at Wembley. Everyone is. It's not even because of today. I'm worried about our last 8 games. Are we gonna get promoted playing like this fucking dog shit? Morecambe, Lincoln, Exeter, Shrewsbury, Cambridge, Bristol Rovers, Burton, Port Vale. We have to beat them all. I'm not joking. We have to fucking beat them all. We've been absolutely battered by Bolton today. We deserved call from this game. I'm not in a mood one bit. Deserved absolutely call. Why could the lads be more vocal? We've been
obliterated. This is no way how you put in a performance going into the championship. No way. If we want to f***ing go for promotion, at Morecambe, we got to f***ing die to get 3 points. Just look at it. We've got to f***ing die to get 3 points next week. And I mean not just next week. We've got to f***ing die to get 24 points for the rest of the season. Shocking. Absolutely shocking. F***ing useless. Today was, without a shadow of a doubt, our worst performance of the entire season. We never win at Wembley. A repeat, an exact repeat of 2016. I'm speechless, angry, furious, and just, that was just a shocker of a final. I've spent all my money for this weekend to see this. That was f***ing awful from the get-go. But us aside, to be fair to Bolton, it's no more than they deserve. They can have their Papa John's trophy. It's just our last 8 games I'm worried about, because that was so poor today. But Bolton fully deserve it from start to finish. We were useless from the get-go. Absolutely useless from the get-go. And it's no more than Bolton deserve. Dempsey was freaking amazing today. Not one of our players had a good game today at all. That just shows it was our worst performance of the season. Not one of our players. Why do we always lose at Wembley? And there go the lads. I love you guys, but you need to seriously change it up if we want to go up. I've never seen a more embarrassing performance of this season from Argyle. And it happens in the Papa John's final. Everyone's gone, I'm still here. But I guess I'm here for the experience as well. But look at them, guys. No more than Bolton deserve, to be fair. You've got to give them credit. They fully deserve today. And well done to every single one of those fans, because they fully deserved it at the end of the day. The players, Evett. And you've got to give them credit, because they've been superb from the get-go of this game. We've been awful. We've got work to do. They deserve it. They fully deserve it. They fully deserve it. I'm crying, sort of, because I just don't know what to expect in these last 8 games. I'm f***ing gutted. But it's not the end of the season yet. Hopefully we go up. Full congratulations to Bolton. They deserved it. We deserved nothing. And now we've got to completely turn this season around, and well, today around more so.
for the last 8 games because I want Championship football next season.
So
guys, obviously earlier before the game, we were joined by as one special guest, Cambridge YouTuber Alfie Ads, part 2. And as promised, as I said back at Pride Park yesterday when I went to watch Derby Ipswich, part 2 promised, the other special guest, Mr. Griff himself.
Hello everyone, how are we?
As a neutral, how was the final today?
It was unbelievable. The atmosphere was crazy. Pretty much build up was class.
I lost my lungs the minute the Janner song got played for Argyle.
Yeah. Obviously, Bolton, I think, outplayed Plymouth today.
They did. Bolton was superb.
Their fans were unreal. And, yeah, I just think they wanted it more today, to be honest.
No, they did. I completely agree.
Obviously, I'm assuming a lot of Plymouth fans will be watching this. You've really got to focus on promotion now.
Yeah, it's as simple as that.
Don't let it knock your confidence. Although, it might do. It might knock your confidence. But, look, you need to get promoted.
It's as simple as that now, yeah.
I'm an Ipswich Town fan. Ipswich have got to get promoted as well. We've been in this league for too long now. And
we've been here for 13 years, so yeah. I know what the pain is like. When I say League One 13 years, not exactly. We mean like outside the Championship for 13 years. Some of those years have been in dreading League Two. Yeah. So that's the league I know you'll never want to go in. It's horrible.
Yeah, but no, I think this is our season to get promoted. But look, today was a great experience. I've been to Wembley many times, and yeah, today was really good. I enjoyed it.
Yeah, that's fair enough. Anyone in particular that was your man of the match today? It was going to be someone for Bolton, isn't it? It's definitely not going to be someone for us. Mumba had his worst game of the season, in my opinion. I bet you that's something you're very happy about because obviously he's Mr. Norwich of our team, isn't he? So, yeah.
I don't know. I don't think anyone really stood out. There was a player, Bolton's right back. I think he was a right back.
Geffen Jones or Declan John. He'll be Geffen Jones, I think.
It was either their right back or their winger. But he was absolutely rapid. He was running with the ball.
Or it could be Connor Bradley on about.
I can't think who it is.
Yeah.
Look, Bolton played really well today, and I've got a lot of respect for both teams. Let's all focus on the league now. And Ipswich, Plymouth, Wednesday, we're all going out.
I still think it'll be us three going out.
I hope so.
But who knows? Like I said, guys, I mean, I'll do more of an outro on the underground later on, but still. Morecambe, Lincoln, the Scum, Exeter, Shrewsbury, Cambridge, Bristol Rovers, Burton, Port Vale, it's make or break. We've got to beat them all. As Neil Warnock once said, and I've just said it a million times after full time, we've got to die to get 24 points this month. So yeah, it's as simple as that. Thank you. Right, we're back. Oh, what a journey. What a bloody miserable day it turned out to be. Look how many people are getting off. I mean, I'm telling you, this is just all our miserableness coming back after that defeat. But there we are. What can you do? It's been a roller coaster of a Sunday, losing 4-0 to Bolton. But we are back. But we have to put it behind us. There's no point dwelling on it because we've got to focus on the league now and get us promoted. It's as simple as that. Hello, guys. As you may as well remember, after that treacherous day at Wembley, it turned out. Yep, treacherous day at Wembley. It ended full time. Plymouth 0, Bolton 4. Basically, there was nothing positive coming out of that final at all. And to be brutally honest, we were completely outplayed, outfought, useless, worthless. Just, there was nothing positive about that final at all. Nothing, absolutely nothing. It was bar none the worst performance of the season. Bar none the worst performance of the season. Worse than any of our hammering League One games or horrible League One defeats that we've had, such as Charlton, Peterborough,
Port Vale at home, Barnsley away. This was worse, a worse performance than all of them. Honestly, I'm not joking. It was that bad. It was that bad of a performance, and it couldn't have been any worse, honestly. But yeah, it was just, there was nothing positive about it at all from our point of view. The players didn't turn up. None of the players turned up. It was just a bar none terrible performance. Just, there was nothing good about it. Mumba had his worst game of the season when he's been undoubtedly our best player and probably League One's best right back this season. But I know he hasn't been in the strongest of forms like he was in the first half of the season, but no, that was bar none his poorest performance, Wembley. And that's the same with a lot of them, but we just didn't turn up one bit. We even played a bit dirty in the second half. We should have had a player sent off. We should have been down to 10 men, if I have to be brutally honest with you. There was just nothing positive about the performance at all. It was a Wembley day to forget. And when we all thought 2016 could have been bad, in that crucial playoff final against AFC Wimbledon, it's even worse today. Today, it was yesterday. I'm filming the outro on Monday, that's why. But anyway, yeah, it was worse at Wembley this season. Absolutely hammered 4-0 by Bolton Wanderers. Bolton, on the other hand, were organised, superb, amazing, played fantastic football. And to be fair to them, they absolutely thoroughly deserved it. I mean, you cannot walk back or come back to Argyle from Wembley saying that we deserved anything from that game. We deserved absolutely nothing from that game. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Bolton deserved every single minute of that final and definitely deserved the trophy, bar none. And that is why they won 4-0. 100% our worst performance of the season. 110% our worst performance of the season. And one person who really stood out for me for Bolton was one of their midfielders, Kyle Dempsey. But yeah, thoroughly deserved, Bolton, and massively well done. Go and enjoy it, Bolton fans. You fully deserved it. As for us, it was an absolute crock of crap, and we have got so much work to do if we want to get promoted this season, because that performance was just not acceptable. I could tell from the minute the game kicked off that none of the players was interested in that final. And like Shuey said after the game, they completely let us down. Every single one of them completely let us down yesterday. I just, honestly, it's just a dreadful performance, honestly. Awful. Bolton fully deserved it, and we deserved nothing. And now that I'm going to sound a bit like Neil Warnock here, but honestly, because we cannot get promoted with performances like that. So I'm hoping that Wembley final was a one-off. I'm really hoping it was a one-off. And after this weekend got me a little bit confident, seeing Sheffield Wednesday draw with Lincoln over the weekend in League One at home. But the team to watch out for me now is Ipswich, after I went to Derby, of course, to see that. Ipswich winning 2-0. The team to watch out for is Ipswich right now. And Ipswich look like they are the team that want to go up more than anyone. So I guess time will tell. But these 8 games are going to be so crucial come end of the season. I hope everyone in that dressing room, every single one of them, have had a huge reflection on themselves from yesterday, from that final, and need to work their socks off and work as hard as they can for these last 8 games. And like Neil Warnock would say, we've definitely got to die to get these points. Genuinely, we have got to freaking die to get 24 points in these last eight games so we can get confirmed automatic promotion, because Ipswich are not going to give up chasing us. Sheffield Wednesday are not going to give up being up there with us. I know they've been terrible lately, but we have to make sure we're getting the points, because if we keep dropping points and Ipswich and Wednesday get points more so than us, we ain't going to get top two this season. And I don't really want Wembley, to be honest. I don't really want the playoff final. Obviously, if we do finish third, then obviously we're going to have to go for the playoff final. But given the circumstances of yesterday, I really do not want the playoff final at all. I really don't. I really don't. So, yeah, genuinely, that game was an absolute disaster. So, honestly, I just can't believe it. But we can't dwell on it, because we have to simply forget about yesterday's cup final and simply move straight on, because these last eight games are much more important and much more crucial. Starting with Morecambe away on Good Friday and then Lincoln at home on Easter Monday. These games are so crucial. Morecambe away, Lincoln at home, the Derby against Exeter away, Shrewsbury away, Cambridge at home, Bristol Rovers at home, Burton at home, and then finishing off the season with Port Vale away. Honestly, it's huge. It's huge, this April is. And yesterday's final is a reminder that it's not going to be easy. Yes, it's not League One. It's a playoff final. Playoff final? Bloody wish it wasn't a playoff final. It's League One, not a cup final. So that means hopefully our performances can be completely different to that disaster against Bolton in that final. And full credit due to Bolton, because that's the first time they've won against us in ages, since the 90s. So fair play to them on that, fair play. But yeah, we have to bounce back. We have to bounce back. And it starts on Friday against Morecambe away. All these last eight games are must wins, all of them. I don't care what people say, they're all must wins. There's no doubt that the hardest ones are going to be Exeter away and Shrewsbury away. 100%, 100%. So yeah, we start off this last month with Morecambe away. Yep, with Morecambe. And it's going to be interesting how we go from there. We're facing an old friend on Friday, Derek Adams, at the Mazuma Stadium. Morecambe are actually not that bad at home, but recently they have been absolutely appalling, so I am quite confident. But who knows? I don't know what Derek's got up his sleeve to face us on Friday, but we have to win. It's a must win, and hopefully Sheffield Wednesday can drop points against Oxford, and Ipswich, high-flying Ipswich, can drop points against Wickham. We have to win against Morecambe on Friday. We have to pull a statement back after that Wembley defeat and get back to winning ways and continue our winning streak from the last two games in League One anyway, because of course we beat Forest Green at home and Accrington Stanley away. And to be fair, both of those games weren't exactly the greatest of performances either, so we need to up our performances. So yeah, it's as simple as that. So yeah, thank you guys for watching the two terrible episodes, that a weekend that has not gone our way at all. And well, next game's Morecambe away. So I will be honest, I don't know if I'm going yet, but we'll see. We'll see. So there we are. That is the end of that, as I walk back into Plymouth in disappointment. I am back in Plymouth now. So we just got to move on from Wembley. Simple as that. I'm already over it anyway, because it is a cup final. And to be fair, like Shuey said, it's a brilliant achievement that we got there anyway. So yeah, we're going to end the video with the traditional. Up the Janners, up the Greens, up the Argyle, up the Pilgrims, up the Plymouth. Come on, you boys in green. Okay, and that is the end, guys. Take care and have a good one. Good night. When they pull on the green, they're all Janners.